Remember the Wii U? Remember when it came out 4 years ago and it was going to not only change gaming, but it was even going to reinvent gaming with that tablet controller second screen? Remember when, according to message board posters, the Wii U had hidden power embedded in it that those third-party developers and hackers just didn't understand, and that only Nintendo's amazing first-party developers did? Well, the Wii U was a total flop instead of being this amazing system, as just about every third party dropped the system, and the Wii U sat with even fewer games coming out on it than the Vita, or fewer games coming out on it than the 360. And there were over 300 games that skipped the Wii U but came out on both the PS3 and the 360. And did I mention that this was despite Nintendo having this one third-party developer reel when the Wii U came out, showing many third parties praising the Wii U? And the Wii U did so poorly that last year Nintendo announced the successor, the Nintendo NX. After around 18 months of rumors and speculation that was hard to distinguish from a fanboy's fantasy that likely ended up with Nintendo destroying Sony and especially Microsoft, and Japan becoming relevant again, the Nintendo NX has been revealed and named the Nintendo Switch. Now, I don't know about you, but the Nintendo Switch is barely a better name than the Wii U. I mean, I don't know about you, but when you're talking with friends, when you tell somebody, "Hey, do you want to play with my Switch?" That does not sound like that they want to play with your Nintendo Switch. That sounds like they want to play with a body part, like they're asking for something sexual. That does not sound like a good game console name. But who am I to talk? I mean, Nintendo, they're geniuses. They know what to call game systems. After all, that's why they call the Wii U, right? Now, enough with making jokes about the name, let's talk about the hardware itself. Now, the Nintendo Switch might as well be interpreted as Nintendo's last attempt at making a handheld and their official leave from the console market. After all, Nintendo's been unable to make a console since the Super Nintendo, with the N64 being designed by another company called Silicon Graphics, and everything after the GameCube being a rehashed version of that hardware. After all, the trailer, which looks like an attempt to pander to the new male college student hipster demographic, which seems to be a lot of the people who buy current Nintendo games and systems, tries to show the Switch as another attempt at doing the whole Sony Vita never stop playing concept that didn't go so well with its ability to function as both a home console and a handheld at once. Now, gee, where have I seen that before? Oh, wait, the PSP Go did that too. And well, it's easy to see why Nintendo did this. Nintendo's console business is as relevant as Mitsubishi cars, and Nintendo's handheld business is losing relevance as little kids just play on mommy's smartphone. At the same time, Nintendo can't come up with anything new like the Wii U proved, so what do? They made yet another variation of the gaming tablet idea, and it even features a Nvidia chipset. Maybe it'll be better this time if it doesn't run Android, since developers won't have a bloated OS running over the hardware to eat up resources. Nintendo wants to get the regular college student and similar kinds of people on the Nintendo Switch, and not the Xbox One, PS4, smartphones, or more increasingly gaming laptops with more bling than an Audi with 30-inch rims and a big subwoofer. And well, an Nvidia chipset would be powerful, because after all, the Nintendo Switch is using a Nvidia chipset, but that is if it's not gimped like other Nintendo hardware has been. For all we know, Nintendo could gimp the CPU speed and cap it like Sony did with the Vita's laughable max clock speed of 444 MHz, which ran at 266 for many games. So much for having a quad-core Cortex. The problem that Nintendo really needs to understand, though, is that third parties must make games for the Switch. Even with internet gamers hailing the Wii U and proclaiming the Xbox One deader than the Atari Jaguar, Microsoft must be doing something right if it not only has outsold the Wii U, but even has third-party games. Hey, it's at least according to rumors region-free this time, though, so you can now import games that the developers either didn't bring to the USA or that would cause people to look at you awkwardly on the bus. Do you think gamers are gonna buy the Nintendo Switch if it lacks even Madden and Call of Duty? I mean, sure, Nintendo fans usually think Call of Duty is as bad as parents walking in while you're browsing Tumblr pages with Nintendo fan art on them, but it sells, and sports games might be the same thing every year, but so is every 21 Pilots song, and look how many views they rack up on YouTube. I mean, sure, Nintendo announced a list of third parties, but they did the same thing during the Wii U. They had this developer reel of the Wii U, and it showed all these developers, including many big-name ones, saying that this was not only the next big thing, but that it was even an ultimate life upgrade. Another problem the Switch needs to address is battery life. Now, the 3DS had pretty poor battery life, and just about any 3DS owner knows what would happen if you left your 3DS in sleep mode. While the Vita and PSP have long-lasting sleep modes, the 3DS will give you a blinking red light after simply a day or two of leaving your console in standby mode. And you'll remember it's on when you see that blinking red light on both the top of the system and on the front of it. Keep in mind, Nintendo built up their portable gaming business on the reputation of offering long battery life and low-cost handhelds. Their handhelds had better battery life than the competition, with the Game Boy using four AA's to go hours on 90s battery technology, compared to the Game Gear or Lynx that used six AA's and required a battery pack or set of rechargeables to use properly due to their more powerful and power-hungry technology. Now, however, even those handhelds have far better battery life than a smartphone, with graphically intense games on phones being notorious for chewing up batteries. And while smartphone makers try to combat this with bigger batteries, sometimes this results in problems like with the Galaxy Note 7's battery explosions becoming one of the biggest product disasters for not only Samsung, but also for technology in general. I mean, one of them caught fire in a plane and then somebody made a Grand Theft Auto mod where you could blow people up with the Galaxy Note 7. That's how much of a joke that became. The Nintendo Switch needs to have a strong battery if it wants to convince gamers that this is a pick-up-and-play device that will let you game on plane trips, bus trips, or trips in the back of Mom's Ford Escape to Disney World. It should probably also be user-replaceable, like with older Nintendo handhelds, because not everybody wants to have to buy a special opening tool and a soldering iron just to replace a battery. It should also use a regular charger because let's look at reality. Everyone and their grandmother has a micro USB charger, and there are even public charging spots for people to plug their phones into. Nintendo has to do this or else people will be having to lug another charger with them on trips. Perhaps the biggest problem with the Switch, however, is the release date. It's coming out in 2017, being yet another system that missed the big Christmas season. Meanwhile, the Xbox One and PS4 came out before Christmas, and while more people care about those systems now than both handhelds, which came out after Christmas. I mean, nothing's as much of a buzzkill as wanting to beg your parents or family to get you a new gaming console for Christmas, only to find out that it's coming a few months after next year, and having to ask mom for money instead so you can buy the Switch when it comes out. It's like buying a used Mercedes-Benz only for the check engine light to be on and find out you won't be able to buy rims and a big booming stereo system, and instead you'll have to pay for maintenance and repairs because parts and stuff cost more for a Benz. It's made worse by the fact that Nintendo announced 18 months ago that they were making the NX with no information about it whatsoever, other than vague ideas, and they blew the opportunity to show it off at E3 when the world was paying attention to Sony's VR headset and Microsoft's Project Scorpio, both of which had clear vision and both of which had games. And the thing is, all the hype from Nintendo fans acting like it's a new ultimate life upgrade isn't enough to make your average everyday gamer at Walmart want to pick it up instead of the Xbox One or PS4. After all, third party matters more than first party. Just look at the PS4 or the 16-bit home computers. But hey, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe the Nintendo Switch will sell well. Maybe it'll be what the Vita was supposed to be originally. Before you waste money on it though, take a look back at the Wii U and look how that went in real life. Do you want to get burnt as hard as that guy I know who bought a Jaguar and Jaguar CD when they were new? After all, Nintendo has the same track record with consoles as HP does with their Walmart laptops. And that's all that needs to be said. Thanks for watching and subscribe for more.